Hey everyone, my name is Paul, and today I'm upgrading the cooling fans in my RAV4. This is sort of an extra project that happened while I was replacing my radiator.
The original Toyota cooling fans are very big and hard to remove from the car. The Flex-A-Lite fans are 2.5 inches thick instead of 5. They look better and it will be easier to work on the car. The 13.5 inch height of these fans is exactly right, but they're too wide. You can see the second fan hanging off the edge of the radiator by 3 inches. By the way, I damaged my radiator cooling fins just now. Don't use your radiator as a table. I'm marking 1 inch to be taken off the cooling fan shroud. That's the width of my ruler. I trimmed the plastic fan shrouds with the angle grinder and also trimmed the channel for the seal. I want both fans to be together in one big fan shroud. Unfortunately, nobody makes a fan setup this size. Now the fans fit perfectly, but I still need to bolt them on. I'll make brackets out of 1/2 inch wide mild steel from Home Depot. It's super soft and easy to deal with if you have a good vise and a hammer. The smaller bend requires a punch. I'll mark where to cut, then trim this piece with the grinder. I'll need a bolt here and a second one here. A 1/4 inch hole is perfect for these brackets. I bolted the bracket pieces onto the radiator and used the drill to mark the plastic fan shroud. I'm not drilling through the fan shroud while it's on top of the radiator. I've done enough damage already using it as a table. With the brackets off and the radiator out of the way, I can drill through the fan shroud. I'm using 1/4 inch by 20 bolts with nylon locking nuts to attach the brackets to the plastic. With all the pieces in place, I can tack weld them. Obviously, plastic burns at this temperature, so I do a quick tack weld followed by a water spray to cool it down. I only need enough weld to keep the parts from moving. I'll do the real welding in the vise away from the fans and radiator. Time for primer, then some blue spray paint. Having the bolts in front of the hood latch support makes the car hard to work on. I'll break off that lower bolt and take it out. The hood latch shares its lower stud with the latch support. I want to bolt the vertical support in from the back, so I'll need to reinforce this part. On the lower radiator support, I'm grinding off the nut and welding a new one to the front instead of the back. I ran a tab through it to make sure the threads are good, then a bit of primer to keep the rust monster away. I'm taking off the nut on top. I want to use one bolt on top instead of two, so I'll need some reinforcement here. I'm marking the areas that will get welded, then cleaning off the paint. I tend to weld things too much, so I'll need to be careful. There's a big wiring harness just behind this piece. The hood latch support needs to be 16.5 inches long. I'm using 1/4 inch holes for everything here. The M6 by 1.0 bolts will fit just fine with a little room for adjustment. I'll paint this piece, then move back to the fans. I installed all the brackets and check this thing out. The fans will bolt onto the radiator and fit better than original. You want to get the top edge of the fans into position first. There are 3 bolts up here. The upper radiator mounts aren't on yet, so it's easy to reach the bolts. There are 4 bolts holding the lower fan brackets. Now it's time for that support, and it doesn't fit. The bracket hits the fans. I'm cutting a channel for clearance, but that's not enough. I need new mounting tabs. The slot needs to be big so this bracket doesn't hit the fan shroud. I installed the top bolt, then marked where the lower bolt should be. I added paint, of course, and now the bracket fits perfectly. I'll need the connectors from the old fans. I just twisted the wires together, black to black and red to blue. Turn the key on, but don't start the engine. The radiator fan switch is unplugged. Both fans turn on. I need to check the airflow direction. It looks like both fans are blowing air behind them and sucking air in from the front. If they blow the wrong way, reverse the polarity on the wires. A proper wiring connection includes solder and heat shrink. Install the heat shrink before you connect the wires. Now the wiring is done on both fans. Just add some zip ties to keep the wires in the right place.
These junky old fans didn't fit very well, so it's nice to have them out of there. At this point, I've fixed most of the things in my RAV4, so if you have one of these cars, definitely check out my other videos, and I'll see you guys next time.